Hello everyone, my name is Cubic, and welcome back to another episode of our Minecraft Let's Play series. Hope you guys are enjoying this series. Are you guys enjoying the series? Let me know in the comments below. But yes, so guys, off camera, I've been doing some things. Some things have happened, things have been tweaked, and so forth. So I've been flattening out this large area here off camera. You guys kind of saw kind of the basic part of it. You know, we kind of messed around with it, didn't really do much, but yeah, so I kind of laid out a little pattern here, and I'm going to explain this pattern in a second. I found a mesa, by the way, and there's a reason I need a mesa as well, but basically, with this auto storage system that we have going on here, my problem is, it's not that I don't have enough iron, it's not that I don't have enough, redstone or anything like that. It's that I don't have enough planks to make all the chests that we need. So what I wanted to do is make a tree farm this episode, and I got a pretty good idea for a tree farm. So I'm thinking, so basically I'm going to be building it out of spruce saplings, because birch saplings. And the reason I want to do it out of birch is because birch saplings will never grow to be like really large, to have a real large tree. You know, it'll always be a harvestable tree at some point. So yeah, that's why I want to do this. So I want to grab a few blocks here. I need to grab some redstone, some minecarts, and so forth, because we're gonna automate this using minecarts. Yeah, that's right. If you're new to the channel, then hello to my minecart world. So let's see here. I need some powered rails. I don't have a whole lot of stuff here to really work with. Okay, so we got some redstone over here as well, so we'll get some of this going. I need some gold for some powered rails. Need some iron for some more rails. By the way, guys, my iron golem farm is working. That's right, guys. Check it out. You guys can see it. Run quickly. Let's see the iron golem. Yeah, he's finally, this iron golem farm is working, and it's producing a decent amount of iron, I would say. I mean, it's got 30 iron in it right now. I haven't played on this world for a real, real long time. But yeah, so let's sleep real quick, because it's becoming night. I've been playing a lot of FTB lately, and I've got, like, speed 3 on, and I feel so slow. Just kind of, like, walking around here. Come on. No! There we go. Alright, so what I'm thinking here is, here's what's going to happen. So what I'm going to do is have the main function, so to speak. This thing is actually going to be one block lower, so it's, this clay stuff here is all going to sit one block lower in the end. So down here we need to make a 5x5 area here to work in, because that's pretty much where a tree will grow and where the saplings will fall. So right here is going to be our area that we're going to work in. So we're going to have to knock out a bunch of this area as well. I thought I did enough digging already. But yeah, we're going to have to knock down two blocks here. Ooh, iron. Yay. So let's get this knocked down. Let me do this off camera real quick, and I'll be right back. Alright, guys, so we got this little trench dug out here. And yeah, I need to get a chest down or something to collect all this cobblestone and stuff that we're getting. So I'm gonna envision this right, but let me put this stuff away real quick. I got a lot of chests here, just like random stuff that we've been getting. It's so much fun. Yeah, I guess that's gonna go in this chest. No, my beautiful chest. Alright, so here's what the plan is. So we're gonna have a hopper minecart running underneath here. Probably should make a crafting table while I'm out here. So we're gonna have a hopper minecart. Let's make one of these real quick. Let's get a hopper made. There we go. So we'll have a hopper minecart here, and a hopper minecart can collect items when they fall. Like, if we were to throw an item on top of here, if there's a hopper minecart sitting that one block below this clay block, it would collect that chicken. So that's the whole concept of this. And because this thing's going to get moved down one block, So we gotta envision that it's here. Then our hopper minecart needs to run on this. But the reason I built this up one is so that way I can access everything and do all the redstone. So I'm going to put in some clay here for our minecart to run on. And the reason I'm doing this is because if I do any running of minecarts anywhere, I don't want to break anything if I'm digging underneath this thing. So this is why we're gonna have some clay here, and it's not gonna be seen. That's why I'm using light gray. And it occurs to me I probably don't have enough light gray. I think I have more in the chest though. So yeah, this should be good. Just get some of this down. Ooh, iron. Give me that iron. Need all the iron we can get right now, because we're going to be using a lot of it in the series. Alright, so let's get this filled in. Alright, guys, so I'm a little bit short on the clay, so I'm just going to fill this in with stone bricks. So I might just do the rest of them with stone bricks, I don't know. Want to get a little bit creative here with how I build things, make things look a little bit nicer than than they've been. So, what we need to do now is make a bunch. We need to make a lot of powered rails and regular rails here. Probably not even enough there. So we have our unloading station. It's going to be actually back one. We might have it do is have it go down a little bit to unload. So that way we're not running into any problems with the farm here. Let's see, so go around here. Yeah, it probably needs to go down one. Like our unloading station might be back in here somewhere. And I will figure a lot of this out eventually, but just kind of getting the basics down. So yeah, unloading station there. Then we need to get a probably a redstone block. Didn't really want to use redstone blocks for this, but we have a lot of redstone, so we can. So we got a redstone block here, and we'll do 1, 2, 3, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This is the pattern I always do. So 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8. Like that. And basically, the minecart's going to run around underneath here and collect all the saplings once they fall. So yeah, I need to make a cr incredible amount of powered rails here. And eventually, even if I make more than I need, I'll eventually use it, trust me. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. If I miscount one, I'm not too worried. Just to keep the minecart going at a relatively nice pace. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Alright, so yeah, let me fill this in off camera, guys. Get all the rails put down and so forth, and then I'll be right back. Alright, guys, so I got the rails put in here, and it's a lot of rails for this tree farm. So gold is definitely going to be something we need to look into and as a farming option here at some point. But I do want to test this thing out and see if the minecart can make it to its destination, like I'm hoping it is. So guessing lever maybe here. There we go. So minecart will travel and it'll just go around collecting items. Hopefully items despawn in like a 5-minute time period, so I doubt this is going to take 5 minutes to get to its destination. But yeah, so minecart just runs around here collecting all the saplings that's going to get here from all of the different trees, and it's just going to keep bouncing back and forth like we have with our factory in there. So we have to kind of set up the same unloading system, which will be interesting. Yeah, so that's how that's going to work. I'm just kind of thinking, do we want to set up an auto replant system? It's tempting. But I think it's going to be a lot more redstone and rails and so forth that we just don't have right now. So I think for right now, what we just need to do is set up the unloading system and turn off this lever here so when it comes back. We need to set up the unloading system here for all of our saplings, and our saplings need to end up kind of in right here, I guess. Would be a good place for them to end up. So yeah, that's the idea here. So yeah, that will come down and that will stop. Nice. So let's break this. And let's start setting up an unloading system here. We'll dig out like a little area here to work in. Nothing too fancy. Okay, so yeah, this block right here needs to be a hopper. Don't have a whole lot of iron. I hope I have enough iron for this. All right, let's get... Okay, this is where my parkour skills do not exist. There we go. We do not have a lot of iron. Okay, let's actually get rid of some dirt here for a second. Iron Golem Farm, can you come in for the clutch right now? That would be nice. I need at least... No. I need at least one hopper, I think. I have the hopper minecart from here, but that needs to be a hopper minecart, so I can't use that. Let's see here. Do I have any iron? I'm not sure. Iron is just... Gold and iron. Those are the two things that I wish I had a lot of. I don't think anything's in there. Anything in the chests? Maybe no. Alright, let me look around here and see if I can find some iron. Alright guys, so I got myself a little bit of iron here. I actually had to dig down to find some. Like, that's how desperate I am for iron right now. So, yeah. So, I think we're going to go ahead and make two hoppers with this iron that we have. And let's get working on this unloading station. I need some chests. Well, double chest should be fine. I forgot comparators and all that. Do I even... I think I have some somewhere up here, I think. So yeah, let me grab those real quick and I'll be right back. Alright guys, so I actually have to make the comparators that I need for this, but... Let's get a hopper there. Powered rail. Then that needs to be a stone brick here. That there. I gotta remember how to do this right. We gotta make like an easier way working here as well. Keep that in mind. All right, so we need to have comparator here, redstone torch here, brick, and then a repeater. Okay, so that should do its thing now. I need like an actual way of getting in and out of here without blocking the minecart, so... But why are you glitched? Stop with your sorcery. Okay, so... That should be good now. So, saplings are going to end up in this chest here. By the end of it, and... If, I don't think birches drop saplings. I don't remember, though. So I do want to test something, though. I've made some droppers here. I thought about maybe coming up with an auto-replant system. I don't know if that... If I'm going to do that or not. Put a dropper there and a chest. A lever. And put an item in there. Okay, it does put that in. Okay, so that's good. That's what we want. So let's get this here. So what I'm going to do is put... I know droppers can be real laggy sometimes, but we're going to go ahead and do this anyway. I got to get a good way getting an angle on this thing. So dropper there. Then a hopper. I gotta get to... I can't get an angle on it. Just dig down. There we go. So then a hopper will exist there, and then we'll have droppers going all the way up to here. Where we'll have a chest. Actually, chest needs to go down one more. Just one. And we'll have a chest here. Will have the items in it. Now, I don't think it can be a double chest because, well, thinking. I don't think it can be a double chest because I don't, you know, double chest, why not? So, now we need to figure out a way to get the items up. So, what I'm thinking is, I need to make another comparator. Do I have stone on me? Yes, I do, okay. I don't have any planks on me, though. I think I have some up here. Let me grab those real quick. Alright, guys, so I got myself some planks here. And what I'm going to do is make a few torches here. And we'll make at least one comparator here. Okay, and then what I'm thinking here is that what's going to happen is whenever... Let's see, it's... this dropper here. It's going to be interesting how to get to this easily. Let's break this chest here. Oh, darn it. Alright, so, and then need to have stone brick one block lower. Well, I can actually stand on that. Wow. Okay, so stone, so comparator there. That's going to need to, just going to dig this out, and we'll cover this over again. So then what I need to have happen is redstone, or actually, you have a repeater, go to a block, there we are, and then that will be redstone wire that needs to run back to this. So that'll be a clock there. And so what needs to happen with that clock is that the clock needs to then power all of this. Let's see. It needs to power each of these droppers individually. Now, it's these ones are pretty easy. These three right here, it's this guy right here that might be a problem because we've got that clock system there. Now, there's a couple things we could do. We could run a... wire out this way and run a repeater to there, and that shouldn't mess with anything, I don't think it will. And then what we'll do is have, we need to just have torches, I think, down here, and we need to figure out, so our torches will be there, our clock there up above. So now we need to just get the redstone wire. So I think if we put power to this, it'll invert. Okay, no, never mind. Power to this block. It'll invert just that one. Yeah, I think I remember that being a thing. I don't really want to do pistons because that's going to be noisy to do this. Could do like repeaters to these guys, but that's gonna get messy pretty quickly. Okay, I don't think I can actually do that because I think that signal's gonna start inverting stuff up there, so we might have to do a repeater for this system, or repeater system for this. Why is it always turning night? I can't run fast to get to my bed quickly. It's always turning night. Alright guys, so I got myself three repeaters here. I'm not exactly sure how I'm going to do this. I'm sure there's super easy ways of doing this. I'm just doing the most complicated way possible. So repeater there. We need to have a repeater to that one. Then off to the side here. Whoops. Didn't want to break that, actually. Off to the side here, we need to have a repeater there. So repeater, repeater. And that should run power to everything. Hopefully. Alright, so then we'll have a redstone. I need to get stone bricks in here so that way I can make sure I don't mine this accidentally someday. So then we'll have redstone wire to there and to there. And then, like, redstone wire there as well. Okay, this is where it gets complex. Because I gotta figure out a way to get all of this with. I'm trying to keep it nice as well. So our clock system is there. So if we put redstone wire there, that should still, let's put an item in here and just see. Okay, so I still pulsed and still put that item in there. Okay, so that's what we wanted. So now what we need to do is get power to this block here, and these blocks down here, which I think we could just do like that. So I think we've accomplished this. I think we have a working clock, a functioning clock. So let's test this thing, why not? So if we put, so if we threw like 24, 29 light gray, put into the system, does it get put into the droppers? Oh, shoot. What am I doing? What did you think was gonna happen, cubic? Oh my goodness, just massive derp there. All right, let me. I gotta reverse what I just did and just do it upside. I did it. All right. Yeah, give me a second, guys. All right, guys, so what I'm doing here is setting up a clock for the droppers, and I'm missing a repeater up there. So I actually just built this wrong. I built this upside down, so I'm rebuilding it. That's why a lot of stuff might be here. But yeah, got our droppers here that are gonna basically need to pulse light gray stained clay up to that chest. So yeah, should be pretty easy. It's just gonna be complicated or very messy redstone, which I can accept. Because I won't be looking at this too much. So, actually, need to build that one too far out. Alright, so let's get stone bricks. So there's our clock. That will do its thing. So what we need to do then is run a redstone wire to here. I'll pulse it up through there. Alright, guys, so welcome back. So I've run into a little bit of a snag here off camera. So I've been doing some building here. I haven't completed the tree farm. Let's kill you with a pickaxe. Lots of mobs around here because I just slept. But you guys will see. We run into a problem here. I am completely out of gold. I only have the 5 gold right here. So we can't complete the second row for our tree farm here, which is a little bit of a problem. Now, I know what you guys are thinking. All right, Cubic, just go mining for gold. You know, what's so bad about that? Well, if you guys have ever watched a UHC, any type of UHC, no matter who it is, whatever, you'll probably know that when you're looking for gold, you're not gonna find any. I've been mining around for a little while, and I just can't seem to get my hands on any gold. So my thought process was, we're kind of in that stage where we need to start looking into some very advanced farms. So I thought about maybe a gold farm using zombie pigmen, and we would, be able to spawn them at a certain area and so forth. So I thought, okay, we can, we can go to the top of the Nether and build a zombie pigmen farm up there. But the only way to get to the top of the Nether and actually bust a hole through the Nether is to use ender pearls. Now, to get ender pearls, we have to kill Endermen. And you guys might see where this is going. So, what I have to do is build an Enderman farm to get ender pearls to be able to get up into the Nether. I could kill a few Endermen when they spawn. It's not guaranteed I get ender pearls, and it's a lot of work to get that. Just, it's not, it's worth me setting up a Enderman farm. So, yeah, Iron Golem farm's been working, which I'm very happy. But yeah, so I'm gonna go off of my own design here for the Enderman farm. We're gonna do a little bit of building. I don't know if I can get all of it done today, but we'll do a little bit at least. So I'm gonna go off of my own design here for the Enderman farm, and actually what I need to do is grab the iron over here. The main reason I want to do that is because we're gonna need some pistons for this. And I want to get the basic concept going, and then I'll build the rest of it off camera so you guys can get a general grasp. But yes, the tree farm is working now. So we got birch trees planted here, and these have been producing a lot of wood for me, which I'm very excited about. So, yeah, let's do that. And then we'll have to replant these here. So, fun part is I can just take this and chuck it on the ground and leave it. Don't even have to worry about putting them back in the chest, even though it would probably be faster. I can just leave them there. All right, so what I'm going to do is I need to craft myself some pistons, and we're gonna need trip wires. We're gonna need pressure, or not pressure plates, trip wires, not pressure plates. Pressure plates don't work because Endermen don't spawn on pressure plates anymore. So, okay, that should be 21 pistons. That's a good start. Do I have any trip wires? That's what I want to know. I don't think I do. I made a bunch of chests off camera, so yeah, I don't think we have any trip wires. Okay, we don't need a whole lot. We can actually just harvest some of these trees down here. Why not? get some of this going. All right, let's grab a sapling here so that way we can replant. All right, so get this going. Let me craft all the things I need off camera, guys, and then I'll be right back. All right, guys, one of the things I have to remember is that I need to actually create a little vine farm here. Okay, place that. There we go. Because we're going to need vines here for this Enderman farm. I'm using Panda's Design, who's a Minecraft YouTuber. Be sure to check him out. But yeah, I'm going to be using his design here for this system. And I have a lot of pistons here, so we should be pretty good. I'm going to need a lot of string, which I think I have a bunch. Yes, I do. Probably only a stack here. Okay, I think just for right now, because we're just setting up the very basics, I will only take the things I really think that I'm going to use while I'm over there. Yeah, I don't see a reason why. And I'll have to grab like hoppers and stuff like that off camera to finish off the Enderman farm. But yeah, so let me head over to the end real quick, guys, and I'll be right back. Alright guys, so I just want to clarify something here real quick. When I said Panda's Design, I'm not going to be copying his design block for block, but the basic concept is what I'm going to be going for here, which is that Enderman will spawn in a 3-high area, and then the second block where their head will sit, or the third block, sorry, where their head will be, will have a tripwire, and that will trigger pistons to push off and push Enderman down to our killing area. So yeah, we have this little platform built out here. We were thinking about, okay, so I was thinking about maybe it would be cool to try and build a base in the Nether, or the End. I keep saying Nether. I said Nether so many times in the Dragon video. It's just, like, ridiculous. But yeah, I don't think we're going to go with that, with a base in the Nether, or in the End. Oh my gosh. Just, you know, kind of figure out a good design here, and go with it, and see, and not really going for a base, because just because we have so much in the overworld, that it doesn't make any sense for us to transfer all that. So what we're going to do is go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Okay, we can't fit that in. All right, building in 8s here, because reasons. And we're going to make a bunch of half slabs. And what's basically going to happen is one block up, and right here is where we're going to hit the Enderman at their feet, and we just need to build a ring like this. Every so often, I think, a ring like this, I think up to about 43 blocks from the original space. So yeah, you guys, this is why I can't do this all on camera, and I'll probably take an episode to do this. So, yeah, what I'm trying to think. I think I'm build it like this. I'm not too worried. I think this part here, and then what we need to do is go like this to make sure that no Endermen spawn here, because I'm probably going to run back and forth getting more cobblestone and so forth. The reason I'm building this out of cobblestone is because it's just the only, it's the resource that I have a lot of, and I don't have the, I can't really have the coal right now to, I guess, build or like do a whole stone brick thing. Really doesn't make much sense. So yeah, what we need to do is go up 43 blocks from where they're going to fall, which they're gonna probably fall on this level here. Let's break that for a second. So where this the glass is beneath here is where the Endermen are gonna fall. So we're at Y level 48. So we need to go up to Y level 93 to make it 43 blocks high. And then once we get to that 43 block number, that's when we need to, you know, do a little bit of, I guess, tweaking. There's going to be some, that's where we're going to have, that's the minimum height that we can drop the Enderman, I believe. So yeah, let me start building rings off camera, guys, and I don't know how much I'll be able to get done this episode, but yeah, in the next episode, hopefully we will have most of this done. But yeah, guys, let's do a time lapse, and I will see you guys once we kind of get this hopefully semi-complete, if not complete. So yeah, Cue the music. So I hope you guys enjoyed that little time lapse there. Basically, I've gotten up to that 43 block where that ladder is. So basically, we're out of time for today's episode. So next episode, guys, we are going to be working on the redstone for this farm. But to give you guys kind of the basic concept, basically, the rings, the reason there's rings here is because the Endermen are 3 blocks high. So we want to keep them in a certain area as they fall, and they don't fall outside of the farm. But, you know, we would like to see the Enderman inside of there, too. So, yeah. Anyway, guys, thank you guys for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed this episode. If so, tap that like button, as well as you're new to the channel. A subscription would be awesome. But anyway, guys, thank you guys for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed. I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.